Once the system operations have been defined, the next step is to identify the application services. Decomposing an application into services could be done following two different decomposition strategies. Each one attacks the problem from a different perspective and uses its own terminology. These strategies are the decomposition using the business capability or the decomposition using the subdomain. With both strategies, the end result is the same: an architecture consisting of services that are primarily organized around business rather than technical concepts. So let's look at the first strategy, which defines services corresponding to business capabilities. To well explain how this strategy helps decomposing a system into services, I will structure the content like this. One, presenting the business capability concept. Two, describing the way we can identify business capabilities. Three, how to link the obtained business capabilities to services. And four, discussing the key benefits of using such an approach. As a concept, the origins of the business capability came from the business architecture modeling. The business architecture model provides a conceptual model of how the business architecture components come together to provide a cohesive and coherent view of an enterprise. For more details about the business architecture models, I invite you to take a look at the link I put in the description. The business capability is something that a business does in order to generate value. The set of capabilities for a given business depends on the kind of business. For example, the capabilities of an online store include the order management, the inventory management, the shipping, and so on. An organization's business capabilities capture what an organization's business is. They are generally stable, as opposed to the how an organization conducts its business, which may change over time. For example, in banking, the deposit check business capability has remained stable, but the manner in which it is done has drastically changed. It wasn't that long ago you deposited checks at your bank by handing them to a teller. It then became possible to deposit checks using an ATM, and today you can deposit most checks using your smartphone. An organization's business capabilities are generally identified by analyzing the organization's purpose, structure, and business processes. Each business capability can be seen as a service, except it is business-oriented rather than technical. Its specification consists of various components, including inputs, outputs, and service-level agreements. For example, the input to an insurance underwriting capability is the consumer's application, and the outputs include the approval or the price. A business capability often focuses on particular business objects, but sometimes it can be decomposed into sub-capabilities. The top-level business capabilities of the food-to-go include the supplier management, the consumer management, the order-taking and fulfillment, the accounting, and so on. Most of these top-level capabilities are decomposed into sub-capabilities. For example, the supplier management is decomposed of the courier management and the restaurant information management. One interesting aspect of the food-to-go capability hierarchy is that there are three restaurant-related capabilities: restaurant information management, restaurant order management, and restaurant accounting. That is because they represent three very different aspects of restaurant operations. So now let's look on how to use these business capabilities to define services. Of course, I will use the food-to-go application to illustrate that. Some top-level capabilities, such as the consumer management and accounting capability, are mapped to services. In the other cases, sub-capabilities like order management or courier management are mapped to services. Later on, it makes sense to change this proposed mapping. For example, separate payments of restaurants and couriers and billing of consumers. Honestly, I can affirm that the decision of which level of the capability hierarchy to map to services is kind of subjective and that there is no rule to follow. But still, this matching is making sense. Identifying services by business capability has a lot of benefits. For instance, Since organizing services around capabilities is stable, the resulting architecture will also be relatively stable. The individual components of the architecture may evolve as the how aspect of the business changes, but the architecture remains unchanged. The second benefit is that identifying services according to business capabilities will lead the development teams to deliver business value rather than technical features, since they will be organized around that business services. The last but not least benefit is that the resulting services will be cohesive and loosely coupled as aimed by the used architecture.